Once upon a time, there was a beautiful girl named Cinderella. She had two wicked stepsisters who...
Wicked stepsisters? Really? What a lie. Cinderella was the one who was wicked. And saying Cinderella was beautiful isn't even fair. She got a magical makeover from a fairy godmother. If you want to know the true story of Cinderella, then listen up. Because this is what really happened. It was the day of the prince, Grandpa. And Cinderella was eating breakfast with her kind stepmother and their two lovely stepsisters, Anastasia and Giselle.
Cinderella dear, would you please pass the tea?
No, I might chip a nail.
Cinderella, would you help me clean Oliver's and Orville's cage this morning?
Are you kidding me, Anastasia? I'm not touching a guinea pig poo. You know I can stand your oversized rotten flop balls.
Cinderella, I have to eat the pumpkin patch before I get ready for the prince's ball. Would you mind lending a hand after lunch?
No can do, Gisella. The pumpkin is fresh with my outfit.
No matter how nice Cinderella's stepmother and stepsisters try to be, no matter how reasonable their request, Cinderella only cared about one thing.
Herself!
I haven't been shopping for, like, almost 24 hours. I don't have anything to wear to the ball.
Now, sweetie, it can't be that bad. How about your white dress with silver stitches?
I wore that to Ariel's birthday party 3 years ago.
Then what about the pink gown with ruffles and lace?
Are you serious? Ruffles and lace are so totally last week. Don't you have any fashion sense?
Well...
That is a poof!
There was a flash of light.
A crackle of noise.
A billowing burst of graceful.
A short, white-haired woman with a sparkling purple pantsuit appeared in the middle of the dining room table. Bibbidi bobbidi boo. What do you need me to do?
Who in the world are you?
Cinderella's fairy godmother, of course. Don't you recognize my wand?
Who cares about your wand? You ruined my breakfast.
The fairy godmother looked down. Sure enough, the pointed sole of my shoe had snapped to Cinderella's buttered toes.
Oh, I'm so sorry, dear. The stop single poop your transmission makes it difficult to see where I'm landing.
Cinderella rolled her eyes and snatched a slice of toast from Anastasia's plate.
Whatever. Just don't let it happen again. Now get to work. I need a dress.
Whoosh!
The fairy godmother waved her wand, and a piece of sky came down, weaving itself around Cinderella, forming a high-waisted, pale blue girl.
Do you expect me to go barefoot?
Whoosh!
Two of these streams of water flew from a fountain in the courtyard, and crystal clear glass slivers suddenly sparkled like diamonds on Cinderella's dainty feet.
Now, how am I going to get to the ball? I can't walk with these things.
Bibbidi bobbidi, all this stuff is for you.
Zuma, chili, poo.
Within a few magical minutes, Cinderella was ready for the princess grandpa. However, her stepsisters and stepmother weren't too happy about some of the fairy godmother's decisions.
That was my best pumpkin for the county fair, and you turned it into a coach. My guinea pigs, they're giant, fuzzy horses.
I don't know where the oval-headed coach driver with white helmet came from, but has anyone seen my white egg?
Since Cinderella had nothing left to do, she spent the day of the day lounging around the house, while her stepsisters scrubbed the guinea pig's cage, pulled weeds in the pumpkin patch, and did dozens of other chores.
That evening, Cinderella climbed into her pumpkin coach, not bothering to offer her exhausted, hard-working stepsisters a ride.
What? Zap! Sizzle! Poof!
Just as the coach was about to pull away from the house, Cinderella's fairy godmother reappeared like a rabbit from a magician's hat.
Oh, Cinderella dear, sorry to bother you, but I nearly forgot. The magical makeover ends in midnight. Be sure you leave the ball before the clock strikes 12. Guinea pigs can get a kind of mood after being turned into horses.
Duh! I know horses can tell time. I'm not, like, stupid, you know.
And with that, the coach ran away. So dust be looking up from the road as the guinea horses pounded towards the house.
As the coach faded from sight, the fairy godmother shook her head and disappeared in a puff of smoke. Cinderella's stepmother turned to Anastasia and Rosella.
Could you girls keep an eye on Cinderella at the ball? I'm not sure she paid attention to the spell ends at midnight thing.
Sure, Mom. We can help.
And Cinderella's stepsisters began the long, dusty trek to the prince's palace.
Of course, you know all about the grand ball. As soon as Cinderella arrived, the prince was smitten and asked her to dance.
They danced together all night long.
Cinderella lost track of time. Blah, blah, blah.
Boom!
Cinderella, it's almost midnight.
Boom!
You need to leave.
Boom!
Quick, before the spell wears off.
Boom!
Naturally, Cinderella ignored her stepsister's advice.
Leave? Are you kidding? You know this is my favorite song.
Cinderella continued to waltz around the ballroom as the clock chimed on.
5 chimes. 6. 7.
By the 8th chime, Cinderella's high blue gown began to fade.
By the 9th chime, small beads of water began forming on her glass slippers.
And by the 10th chime,
what's going? Ow!
2 angry guinea pigs scampered up the prince's suit and jumped down on his royal gloves like a pair of miniature T-Rexes.
No!
Run, Cinderella! Run!
On the 11th chime, Cinderella sprinted from the ballroom. The prince followed after her, plucking a guinea pig from the tip of his nose.
Wait! Come back! The palace doesn't usually have rats.
Cinderella and
I'll call the royal exterminator!
As Cinderella stumbled down the palace stairs, one of the glass slippers dropped from her foot, but she didn't stop to retrieve it.
The prince bent and picked up the slipper, hoping it would use it to find Cinderella.
But boom!
The clock's 12th and final chime reverberated into the night.
Huh?
The glass slipper melted away, dripping through the prince's fingers and leaving a puddle on the palace stairs.
The last thing the prince saw was Cinderella running barefoot down the dusty road,
dashing past a large pumpkin and a large rabbit,
being chased by two squealing guinea pigs.
But at least some of us still live happily.